I'm going to be trying something, and I thought you'd want to be part of it. You've been right all along. What I did with Justice was unnatural. It should never have happened.
I'm glad you finally understand that.
I can't help mages like this. Not while I am everything the Templars fear about magic. I need to be free of this curse.
I never heard of anyone getting unpossessed.
I've spent the past 3 years researching the methods of Tevinter Magisters.
Why am I not surprised?
They're the only ones who have ever sought to reverse spirit possession, not just behead the victims. I believe I have a formula for a potion that can separate Justice and me, without killing either.
Is it dangerous?
There are always dangers with magic. But I believe this will be worth the cost.
That was going to be my next question.
I knew you'd stand behind me in this. Even if...
What?
Nothing. I've gathered most of what I need, but there are some outlandish ingredients I was hoping you'd help me collect. A powder the Tevinters call Celepetre, and a small amount of Drakestone.
Is it just a potion? Is there anything more to this ritual?
No, no ritual. Just mix the ingredients up and... boom. Justice and I are free. And we can take our rightful place among free mages.
What is Drakestone?
The Tevinters used to mine it for their apothecaries. There should still be deposits in the bone pit.
Where would we find Celepetre?
It's a crystal that forms from concentrated manure and urine.
Ugh. We can't just buy it somewhere.
It's not used by mages here. There's no reason for any merchant to stock it. I suggest we search the sewers. There's an entrance not far from here in Darktown.
We're not looking for virgin's blood or the tongue of a hanged man or anything, are we?
Well, you know Tevinters. They can't throw a Wintersend party without a human sacrifice or two. But I promise, everything in my research says there's no blood magic involved.
Here, boy. I've something to wet your teeth on. Freshly confiscated mutton, just for you. Have at it. Just checking on my best guardsman. He's helping the men to learn healthy respect and how to run.
Now that you're the champion of Kirkwall, seems everyone wants something, don't they? Mistress somehow. Thank you.
can enter the sewers from here to look for the cellar Petrae. Are you ready?
Let's go.
Hold your nose. We'll have to get pretty close for me to tell what we're looking at. I know it isn't my place to criticize, but are you sure about Fenris? He seems less a man to me than a wild dog.
We're not together. Not anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry. Though it's probably for the best. This is it. The cellar Petrae should have formed right under here. Oh, I don't want to touch that. Let's see if we can find a few more deposits. Let's see if we can find a few more deposits. Find a few more deposits.
Watch your step.
Done.
Let's see if we can find a few.
You
That should be plenty. Thank the Maker. We still need the Drake Stone from the Bone Pit.
Good reason to call it the Bone Pit. Long ago, slaves that dropped dead from exhaustion were thrown into a pit for all the others to see. It served as intimidation and convenient disposal.
Are you ready to go in?
Ready as I'll ever be.
We'll have to look for Drakestone deposits along the sides.
Trap! Open!
This looks like a Drakestone deposit. I need a scraping from the deepest part. There should be more further in. There should be more further in. There should be more further in.
I don't like the looks of this. That should be. Watch your step. Okay.
That should be enough. Thank you. I wouldn't have asked just anyone to venture in there for me. There is one more thing. but we must discuss it privately. really need me along for...
A dragon attacked your mine. Everyone is dead.
Dear Maker, what of my equipment? Did it seem salvageable?
No, and neither did the workers who died trying to save it.
Oh, my heart! So many years of investment! I am ruined! Ruined! I'm sorry, Champion. I appreciate your help, but I sank all my coin into that rotten mine. I have nothing left to pay you.
Give me the bone pit. Perhaps in a few years I can get it back in order.
What? Ha! Fine, take it. I wash my hands of this cursed venture.
Good day, Captain Abilene.
You were courageous to speak openly against the Knight Commander. Your words did not fall on deaf ears. Several nobles are discussing, quietly, what to do about Meredith. I cannot tarry here for risk of Templar spies. If you would make common cause with us, read this.
I could use all the allies I can get.
Secrecy is paramount. I'll communicate by messenger if the need arises. Make a look after you, Hawk, and our fragile endeavor.
Captain? side of Orzammar.
Captain?
Have you located any Qunari blades?
This is what I've found.
Do you require gold for this task?
It's customary.
Very well.
Ah, the champion of Kirkwall. Your reputation precedes you. Forgive me. I should introduce myself properly. My name is Nancio Caldera Llanos. I am a noble from the beautiful country of Antiva.
It must have taken a lot of practice to say that all in one breath.
It's mostly to impress the ladies, I assure you. I've come to ask your help, champion. Hiding among the Dalish is an elven assassin I've been chasing for months. He's a master manipulator who will endanger even his own kind to ensure his survival.
You don't seem the type to hunt assassins. Why are you after him?
At first, it was merely duty to Antiva. But after losing so many good men to him, it became personal. He's nothing but a murderer, a thief, and a liar.
You want me to use my wily ways to find out where the Dalish are hiding this elf?
That is part of it, yes. This elf is very dangerous, and he must be brought in before he kills again. I've heard of your dealings with the Dalish. I was hoping you could go where my men could not. Find out where the assassin is hiding, and apprehend him.
I'll see what I can do.
One of the Dalish, a woman named Variel, he's a friend of his. I suggest speaking with her first.
We won't be here when you get back. We got a campsite outside the city. Look for us there.
I shouldn't have worn these shoes.
Welcome back, my friend. My store has never been better stocked, thanks to you. Although I have nothing else to ask you to find, you're quite welcome to bring back any rare specimens you may come across. I'd be more than happy to craft something just for you. It's the least I can do for the champion of Kirkwall.
I took this fire gland from a high dragon just outside the city.
You killed a high dragon? Incredible. Let me see the fire gland.
It was either her life or mine. I chose mine.
And that I am glad to hear. This fire gland is a remarkable specimen. Wait here. I know exactly what I can craft from this. This turned out beautifully. Something worthy of our champion. I hope you can put it to good use.
Thank you.
Trap!
Greetings, champion. That is what they call you in your city, isn't it? Did you need something?
I hear there is a criminal hiding among the Dalish.
He is not among us. This criminal of yours is set up in a cave away from our camp. He said there would be people looking for him, and to tell anyone who asked where he was.
I thought the point of hiding was not to be found.
He said he didn't want to endanger our people by asking us to lie for him. Not something you'd expect from a cruel and evil murderer, is it? He'll be waiting for you at the cave. Good luck trying to reach him, however.
Strange. The man wants to be found.
It is good to be among my people.
Andaranatishan, child. I pray that the path before you was...
There is one more thing I would ask of you, Hawk. And I can't tell you why. I must get inside the Chantry without being seen. Will you talk to the Grand Cleric for me? Distract her long enough for me to do what must be done.
What do you want me to talk about?
Food? The weather? What does it matter? No, talk of mages. Give her one final chance to hear what we have suffered. To pick a side. Perhaps she'll be more inclined to listen to you.
What are you plotting?
You would not thank me if I told you. If you support freedom for mages, help me. That's all I can say.
What is it you don't want me to see?
I would not tell you my plans, Hawk. You have made it plain where your sympathies lie. I will ask you straight then. Has nothing you've seen changed your mind? Will you help me free the mages of Kirkwall? Or will you stay at the side of the Night Tyrant?
Was this ever about you and justice? Or have you lied this whole time?
I lied. There is no potion. But what we have gathered will bring freedom for more than just me and justice. It will help mages throughout Phaedus. In the face of that, one lie means little.
What do you need me to do?
You surprise me again, Hawk. I'm glad these years spent ranting haven't been in vain. I promise, whatever happens, it's on my head. It will not come back on you. Go to the Chantry. Talk to the Grand Cleric. I will join you when I'm done. Frankly, I prefer the refugees.
You look lovely tonight, my lady.
Oh, you are too kind. I am so honored to have the champion in my home. I will call for refreshments. Talia? Oh, she is so slow, this girl. Come, let us chat while we wait.
You're extremely cheery for a woman whose son is wanted by the Templars.
Emil? Oh yes, the Templars were asking about our poor boy recently. I haven't seen Emil since he was taken to the Circle. He was just 6. You can tell the Templars not to worry. I am sure Emil will turn himself in soon. He is a good boy.
Dulce! What have you done? You should have told the boy to throw himself at the mercy of the Templars.
Guillaume! Darling!
Don't darling me, Dulce. He's been telling people he's our son, that you gave him gold.
Guillaume! Darling! We have guests!
Don't stop on my account. This is fascinating.
I didn't mean to lie to you, champion. I barely saw Emil. I didn't think it was worth mentioning. I gave him some money. Not too much. He said he wanted to start a new life.
New life? His new life is spent in low-town taverns, getting drunk on cheap wine. It's a wonder the Templars haven't found him yet. Help us, please, champion. Emil is not a blood mage, just a foolish boy. Don't let the Templars kill him.
Blood mage? Oh, Guillaume, don't say that!
Please, save my son's life.
It looks like the Comtesse is in greater danger of expiring at the moment.
Yes, Dulce. She's high-strung. An acquaintance spied Emil in the Hanged Man not long ago. He should still be there.
The Hanged Man? Oh, but that place is filthy.
Come, Dulce. Perhaps you should lie down.
Orlesians.
foolish boy.
Ah!
luck on you.
Well, woof to you too. A ruff.
Like the shiny?
I'll find you as soon as I'm done. Thank you.
You've done a great service
to the city by defeating
the Canary. Blessed art thou who exists in the sight of the Maker.
Sing of the charms.
Maker's blessing, champion. Have you come to pray?
So, hypothetically, if there were a group of people being brutally subjugated by another, wouldn't the Maker favor the oppressed?
You speak of mages. It's no secret that you count apostates among your friends, champion. You have done much to fan the flames of rebellion here. We must give Meredith and Orsino time to work out their differences. No good can come of showing favor to one side.
Couldn't you solve this problem if you just spoke out?
How would that help? Both sides make good points. Both have flaws.
At some point, right must be decided.
For 1,000 years, the Chantry has had to find the balance between them. That hasn't changed here.
I guess that means you're not ready to disband the Templars and set every mage free.
I feel for the mages, I do. I would not wish to be locked in the gallows. But I cannot take sides. We are all the Maker's creatures, but magic allows abuses beyond the scope of mortals. I only hope I can balance the needs of everyone. For if it comes to war, it is the people of this city who will lose.
There you are. I've been looking for you all over.
Your Grace?
Your soul is troubled, child. I hope you found a balm for it here.